Perhaps the only question that tops whether there is life outside Earth is whether there is intelligent life elsewhere in the universe. Many people believe we've been visited by intelligent aliens, but the evidence is anything but overwhelming. Since the first confirmed discovery of an exoplanet in 1995, astronomers have grown more confident that the universe must harbour other civilizations. Their hope is to find other worlds with signs of microbial organisms, or better yet, find evidence that would suggest the existence of intelligent extraterrestrial life. The sheer number of stars suggests the universe is teeming with life.
If you look at the numbers, first, the ingredients of life on Earth, they're not special. We're made of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. These are the most common ingredients in the universe. So you can't appeal to our special chemistry because it's everywhere. Now, how many locations might you have life? If life existed on a planetary surface, how many planets are out there? Well, we've got an inventory in the making right now. The Kepler telescope, it gave us a list of 1,000 planets out there orbiting stars that are nearby the sun. And that's just in our little pocket of the Milky Way galaxy. So you run the numbers, and you realize it would be inexcusably egocentric to suggest that we were alone in the universe.
If civilizations do not always destroy themselves shortly after discovering radio astronomy, then the sky must be softly humming with messages from the stars. This was a quote from Carl Sagan, who was pessimistic about civilizations being able to survive their own technological adolescence, which is the transitional period when a culture's development of nuclear power, bioengineering, and other powerful capabilities could easily lead to self-annihilation. The search of evidence of intelligent alien life is ongoing, with increasing interest both by the public and by astrophysicists alike. The current method is to search for radio transmissions using radio telescopes. There is a famous saying that when you lose your key in the dark, you tend to look near where the light is. Regardless of the fact that you lost the key in the dark, this observational bias, which occurs when people only search for something where it is easiest to look, could hinder us from finding signs of interstellar conversations. But perhaps a more simpler explanation is that we wrongly judge ourselves to be amongst intelligent species in the galaxy.
And so anyone who's actually studied the problem would say, sure, the statistics strongly argue in favor of life. Now, whether it's intelligent life that we would call intelligent, you want to lose sleep? Maybe there's life that's so intelligent, it doesn't consider us to be intelligent. We came up with our own definitions of what intelligence is. Imagine they are so brilliant, they look at this, they wouldn't even waste their time. Then you walk by a worm in the street that just crawled out gasping for air after a morning rain. Do you say, gee, I wonder what the worm is thinking? I wonder, no, you don't care.
Surely if there is intelligent alien life out there, then the areas of the galaxy that are near Earth should have been visited by them. This is not what has been found so far. There is no obvious sign of intelligent extraterrestrial life in other star systems. Scientists working on a contest issued by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory found out that it would take around only 90 million years for human civilization, with no warp drives, to occupy large swathes of the Milky Way. That would seem like a really big number, but is nothing compared to how many years the galaxy has been around. And if that is the case, then why haven't we seen any signs of colonization from an alien civilization?
It has been argued that if you're a civilization that colonizes the galaxy, that it's a self-limiting exercise. Why? Because we start here on Earth, and you take that planet, I take this planet. And now we have both have offspring that are just like us, and we want more planets, all right? We reach a point where expansion is not possible because we are warring with ourselves to gain the territory that each other has obtained. So it has been argued sociologically that the very act of wanting to colonize is self-limiting against successful colonization of the galaxy. Because to colonize the galaxy, it has to be done in an organized way. You take this sector, I take this sector, but if I want territory and I want it now, I want that territory, not this other one. In fact, I want it all. That kind of attitude breeds violence. It breeds war, intragalactic war. So it may be that the very kind of civilization that could peacefully colonize a galaxy is not the kind of civilization that would colonize the galaxy at all.
One possible solution to the Fermi paradox for why we don't see alien civilizations is the Great Filter Hypothesis. The Great Filter says that intelligent interstellar life forms must first take many critical steps, and at least one of these steps must be highly improbable. For example, a first great filter through the universe is the incapability of a planet to harbor life in a star's habitable zone. Another filter would be the inability for life forms to reproduce. Another filter is the inability for complex organisms to use tools. And perhaps the most important great filter for a given civilization is the prevention of galactic colonization due to self-annihilation. Indeed, this great filter would explain why we haven't seen evidence for intelligent alien life so far. Another interesting explanation or solution for the Fermi paradox is that at a certain point in time, intelligent biological life undergoes the next phase of evolution, which is the digital phase. And after a civilization becomes predominantly artificial or digital in nature, which is to say, it internalizes and runs simulations of the world inside a computer, it loses interest for galactic colonization. It seems that whatever explanation is offered to account for the lack of evidence for extraterrestrial life, it is immediately and rightfully countered with the math argument that there are vast numbers of stars in the observable universe, and so at least one civilization should be able to overcome any great filter and leave signs of its presence. Going back again in circles and turning the Fermi problem into a paradox.
There was a monk back just pre-Galileo, just a little pre-Galileo, his name is Giordano Bruno, who had just learned about Copernicus's work, that maybe the sun is in the middle of the known universe instead of Earth. Well, if Earth is just one of the planets, and Earth has life, maybe other planets have life. Think about it. Once you realize that Earth is one of many, it opens up a whole world of questioning. And he said, well, if that's the case, then, and if all these lights in the night sky are suns just like our sun, then maybe they all have planets. Then maybe the whole universe is teeming with life.
A study published in 2017 suggests that due to how complexity evolved in species on Earth, the level of predictability for alien evolution elsewhere would make them look similar to life on our planet. One of the study authors notes, like humans, we predict that they are made up of a hierarchy of entities, which all cooperate to produce an alien. At each level of the organisms, there will be mechanisms in place to eliminate conflict, maintain cooperation, and keep the organisms functioning. There is also research in assessing the capacity for life for developing intelligence. It has been suggested that this capacity arises with the number of potential niches a planet contains. The history and evolution of life on Earth potentially has much to teach us about the existence of alien life throughout the galaxy. But when push comes to shove, we have to find clear-cut evidence to infer the existence of extraterrestrials. After all potential explanations for the lack of evidence are exhausted, it only becomes rational to consider the possibility that we might be in fact alone in the galaxy, if not in the entire universe, and what that could mean for our civilization.
I tend to restrict myself to the galaxy. Do think it's possible that at the moment there's one civilization in the Milky Way, and that's us. And I think that's important, actually, if you're looking for meaning, or you're looking for how we should behave even politically. That has a bearing to me. I mean, imagine that we're the only place where there is intelligence in this galaxy. And how should we behave? Should we actually, notwithstanding the fact that we're tiny and fragile things and insignificant physically, should we consider ourselves extremely valuable in that respect? Because I would go as far as to say there would be nowhere else where meaning exists. Because meaning, it's one of those things that scientists don't talk about very much, although Richard Feynman, one of my great heroes, did talk about it. There's a quote where he says, "What is the meaning of it all?" It's a great essay called The Value of Science. And so what is self-evidently true is that meaning exists here because it means something to us. So that's kind of an obvious statement. Your life means something to you and me. and so meaning exists. But I think it is a local and temporary phenomenon. I think it emerges. Meaning emerges from configurations of atoms, which is what we are. We are simply that. We're nothing more than that. We're very, very rare configurations of atoms, I think. And so that means that we are, if you go all the way down that line of logic, we are the only island of meaning in the galaxy. I think it's more wonderful and more challenging to us, because we have to take responsibility for it, to say we should operate such that we are it in this galaxy. There's nothing else. I'm sure there are other civilizations out there in the universe, because there are 2 trillion galaxies. I just can't believe this hasn't happened in other places. The question is, how often does it happen, and how widely spaced are the civilizations? And I think they're very widely spaced, and I think there may be 1 or 2 per galaxy on the average.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.